administer that northern territory, but we've been up in the mountains of Tennessee, places and those things. And God's been good, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And one brother said he'd get gooder and gooder all the time.
Amen.
Amen. So we had an outpouring of the Spirit at the church this morning where we were at. Where we're in supply pasture over in, well, I don't know, they call me associate pastor. I'm just jumping in where I need.
That's right.
But God is so good in the house this morning.
Amen.
And I guess I could say what Jamie said, he shook him with faith. Sometimes we need a shaking, I tell you. There was more of a good, refreshing shaking.
Amen.
And I'm telling the church, the time we're living in, and the weariness in the land, and the troubles and problems we're facing, we see all the time. Boy, it's good every now and then to get in the spout where the glory's coming out.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. I honor this pastor that's here tonight. And I just walked in and praise the Lord. Here we are.
Come on. Amen.
And we'll sing that song. If there's anything left in the voice, I preached one of those. Praise the Lord. Well, we're working on the building. This Holy Ghost building. I'm talking about building for my Lord, for my Lord. Are you working on your building? This Holy Ghost building. I'm talking about building for my Lord, for my Lord. Well, are you working on your building? This Holy Ghost building. I'm talking about building for my Lord, for my Lord. Well, if I was a sinner, I'm going to tell you what I would do. Watch me take sin and turn to God, start working on the building. This Holy Ghost building, this Holy Ghost building. I'm talking about building for my Lord, for my Lord. Well, if I was a drunkard, I'm going to tell you what I would do. Why quit that drinking and turn to God, start working on the building to this Holy Ghost building. This Holy Ghost building. Why I'm talking about building for my Lord, for my Lord. Are you working on the building? This Holy Ghost building. Why I'm talking about building for my Lord, for my Lord. It's the Holy Ghost building. I'm talking about building. This Holy Ghost building. For my Lord, for my Lord. Well, if I was a gambler, I'm going to tell you what I would do. I'd quit that gambling and turn to God, start working on the building too. It's Holy Ghost building, it's Holy Ghost building. Well, I'm talking about building for my Lord, for my Lord. Are you working on your building, that Holy Ghost building? Well, I'm talking about building for my Lord, for my Lord. Well, if I was a liar, I'm going to tell you what I would do. I'd quit that lying and turn to God, start working on the building too. The Holy Ghost building, it's the Holy Ghost building. Well, I'm talking about building for my Lord, for my Lord. Well, if I was a preacher, I'm going to tell you what I would do. I'd keep right on the preaching and working on the building too. Holy Ghost building, oh, it's Holy Ghost building. I'm talking about building for my Lord, for my Lord. It's Holy Ghost building. I'm talking about building a Holy Ghost building for my Lord, for my Lord. I'm talking about building for my Lord, for my Lord.
Life is so easy when you're up on the mountain and you've got peace of mind like you never know. And if things change and you're down in the valley, well, don't lose faith, for you are never alone. For the God of the mountain, he's still God in the valley. When things go wrong, he'll make it right. And the God of the good times, he's still God in the bad times. God of the day, he's still God in the night. You talk faith when you're up on the mountain. Talk comes so easy when life's at its best. But it's down in the valley, trials and temptations, that's when faith is really put to the test. For the God of the mountain, he's still God in the valley. When things go wrong, he'll make it right. And the God of the good times, he's still God in the bad times. God of the day, he's still God in the night.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, God.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. How true it is. How true it is.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I tell you, it seems like there's valleys to be found these days, but thank God a valley ain't nothing, you know, but a ditch that's got two ends to it. And the thing of it is, we don't take out a 401k and take a retirement plan out in the valley.
That's
we
right.
Keep looking to the mountain.
Yeah.
That's what the psalmist said, amen?
Yes, hallelujah.
Psalms 122 or 21, 22 of these said, I will look unto the mountain.
Yes.
Of the hills which comes my help.
Amen.
And my help comes from God who made heaven and earth.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. We always got to look to the mountains, amen? And that's been our testimony song for several years because, like all children of God, we have mountain experiences and we have valley experiences.
That's right.
Amen. But we always keep pressing back to the mountain.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I said this before, and they have said it here. I don't know. I say so many things in so many places. I forget where it got from. Half time where I said it, and who has said it to me anymore. But I found in my 26, going on 27 years of ministry, that my mountain experiences is the place to take advantage of what God's doing. And listen very attentive to what he's saying. Glean very carefully on what you've experienced. Because when you hit the valley, that's when we produce the fruit.
Amen.
I traveled this world and parts of this country. And I assure you, the best things that ever grow in the valleys.
That's true.
Some of the most best vineyards and things ever grew in Israel grew in the fertile valleys of Jezreel and places like that. So God, amen, he may have you in the valley for a while, but it's in the valley where we produce the fruit. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
And that ain't even where I want to go tonight, praise the Lord. Anyway, y'all start it, so I'll try to finish it.
Glory to
the Lord. I felt the Holy Spirit would come in the door, and some needs was being met, some souls was being blessed, and praise the Lord. That's what it's all about, amen?
Amen.
Anyway, I want to speak for a few moments of time out of the book of Samuel. 1 Samuel 16, this was kind of living in my spirit coming over here. And I told Don, I said, I don't know what God will do, but I just know we're going. And just, you know, sometimes you just got to jump in and be available. And it ain't always in our great ability, but just being available. But he wants our availability. Anyway, praise the Lord. How many love Jesus this evening?
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. No time to give up now, is it?
Nope.
We're on the, as they say, we're on the last leg on the way home. Amen.
That's right. Thank you, Jesus.
1 Samuel 16. And I want to speak on a few minutes here in 1 Samuel 16. And first verse 1 says, and the Lord said unto Samuel, how long thou mourn for Saul, seeing I have rejected him from reigning over Israel? He says, fill thine horn. He says, fill your horn with oil. Amen. And go, hallelujah, and I will send thee to Jesse the Bethlehemite. And he says, for I have prepared me a king among his sons. And Samuel said, how can I go if Saul hear it he will kill me. And the Lord said, take an heifer with thee, and say, I have come to sacrifice to the Lord, and call Jesse to the sacrifice, and I will show thee what thou shalt do. And thou shalt anoint unto me him whom whom I name unto thee. And Samuel did that which the Lord spoke or spake, and came to Bethlehem, and the elders of the town trembled at his coming, and said, Comest thou peaceably? And he said, Peaceably. And I come to sacrifice unto the Lord. Sanctify yourselves and come with me to the sacrifice. And he sacrificed a man. He sanctified Jesse and his sons and called them to the sacrifice. And it came to pass that when they were come, that he looked on Eliab, and he said, Surely the Lord's anointed is before him. But the Lord said unto Samuel, Look not on his countenance or on the height of his stature, because I have refused him. For the Lord seeth not as men seeth, for man looketh on the outward appearance, but the Lord looks on the heart.
Amen.
Then Jesse called Abinadab, if I said that right, and made him pass before Samuel, and he said, Neither hath the Lord chosen this. Then Jesse made Shammah to pass by, and he said, Neither hath the Lord chosen this. And again Jesse made seven of his sons pass before Samuel, and Samuel said unto Jesse, The Lord hath not chosen these. And Samuel said unto Jesse, Are here all thy children? And he said, There remaineth yet a youngest, and behold, he keepeth the sheep. And Samuel said unto Jesse, Sit and fetch him, for we will not sit down till he comes hither. And he sent and brought him in, and now he was ruddy. And the word ruddy means red-headed, and well of a beautiful countenance, and goodly to look to. And the Lord said, Arise, anoint him, for this is he. And then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of his brethren, and the spirit of the Lord, amen, came up on David from that day forward. So Samuel rose up and went, amen, to Ramah, and the spirit of the Lord departed from Saul, and the evil spirit from the Lord, troubled him. And when we see this story here in the picture of this story, we see Saul as a type and a shadow of the request of people. The arm of flesh always requests what it wants and what it needs. But God, amen, in his infinite wisdom and knowledge, knows by the Spirit of God what we need, who we need, and how we need, and how to get it to us in the need. Can you say amen? And so he says, How long are you going to mourn for Saul, seeing I have rejected him? And because, he's refused my counsel, and he hasn't hearkened to my obedience, and he has not obeyed me in the things I've told him to do, and I have rejected him from being king. And he was basically telling Samuel, it's time to get up. You've depleted the oil. The horn is empty. And it's time to get up and quit mourning on what I have refused and what I have rejected. It's time to get up and fill the horn. And the horn represents the authority of God. The oil represents the Spirit of God. The oil represents, amen, what brings the anointing of the Holy Spirit. And the oil represents God's moving, amen. When the oil is flowing, God's moving. When the oil is flowing, God's anointing. When the oil is flowing, things are happening. When the oil is flowing, lives are being changed. When the oil is flowing, praise the Lord, people get blessed. When the oil is flowing, people get out of self, and they get into, amen, the deity of God. They get out of the super, out of the natural into the supernatural, and they get in the presence of God, where the fullness of joy is. But he said, Samuel, the people are hurting, and people are scattered, and my people don't have a leader no more, but I got me a man, and he's coming out of the tribe of Judah. I got a man appointed that's going to bring a bloodline, that's going to bring a king, that's going to bring a savior, that's going to bring somebody that will bring it all back into my perspective, all back into my
wheel, all back into my power. I got a man praying out already. He was born, amen, in the line of Jesse, and he's ready. He's going to be raised up. He's redheaded. He's in my favor. I chose him, amen. In the eyes of the world, he's a stinking shepherd, but in the eyes of heaven, he's a king eternal. Amen. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Can I go on and preach a little bit?
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. And in the view of this thing, how many know that in my journeys and travels, I'm in a place and a time, in my life, I don't want to waste any more oil. Hallelujah. I don't want to waste any more oil on what God has not put his hands on, what God has not anointed. I don't want to put my hands on it. I don't want to waste another word on a dead testimony. I don't want to waste another word on something that God ain't called. I don't want to waste any more oil on something that refuses to live. I don't want to waste any more oil on something that just determined it's going to die. I don't want to waste any more oil on the rebellious people. I don't want to waste any more oil. The whole world's up ahead, and I pray for the tide. I don't have time to waste any more precious oil. And so therefore, church, it's time in America we quit wasting the oil and we fill our horns with fresh oil. And David said in Psalms 92, the Lord will fill your horn with fresh oil and anoint your head with fresh oil. And I tell you, church, we need to thank God for it.
Amen.
Amen. In our lives. Can you get amen?
Yes, we do.
I stopped one day in my tracks and just began to think about this and how that, I can glean back over the years and how I can look back, Pastor, and realize I wasted all on that. And I wasted oil on that, and I wasted oil on this. And God says the oil is a precious thing. And the Bible tells us in Matthew 25 that the oil, amen, is a representation of the Holy Spirit flowing in our lives, that we are to have our lamps filled with oil, and a supply of oil to go with them, and our wicks trimmed and burning bright. Hallelujah, because let me tell you something. God is looking for a church, looking for a people where the oil of the Holy Spirit is flowing out of people. Lives, and it brings a change. It brings an anointing. I don't know about you, Pastor, but I'm so tired of dead, dead, dead. I say dead, dead, dead. Religion across America and dead, dead people that have no oil running in their life. And dead as the dead hand. They're dead in graveyard. Dead in the last year's birthday. I said, give me something got some oil on it. Give me something that can be breathed up by the saints of oil. Give me something that's got some residue. Give me something that man that God's called out and said, I don't care what they think it is. When I put my hand on it, it's going to live. It's going to breathe. It's going to come alive. I'm going to put my hand on it.
Amen.
You know, my heart comes from that.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
And we as a people in a society in the church world are wearing ourselves to frazzles, depleting ourselves, killing ourselves, absolutely wrecking our brains on things and situations. Amen. It's time we quit turning the oil bottle over on something that God says, how long are you going to mourn over it? How long are you going to weep over it? Get up, wash your face, anoint yourself, pour some fresh oil out of yourself, and get ready, amen. I'm sending you over to Bethlehem. I'm sending you over to the house of bread. I'm sending you, amen, where I'm operating. And when you get there, you're going to see heaven meet with earth, and the glory, amen, flood man's soul.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. And amen, little fella. He's been getting right with me. Hallelujah says he was goodly, amen, goodly to look to. And the Lord said, arise, anoint him. Hallelujah. How many love to be anointed?
Yes.
Oh, I'll tell you one thing. I'm like King David. Lord, take not the Holy Spirit away.
Amen.
Amen. The anointing of the Holy Spirit is more precious than gold and silver.
Amen.
It is more precious because let me tell you something. It's going to take the anointing, that same anointing, Bible says it, That same anointing that raised up Jesus from the dead will quicken your mortal bodies. It's going to be the same anointing that brought him out of the graveyard on the third day. Amen. And appeared to men some 40 days. Amen. That same anointing that carried him back into heaven is going to be the same anointing one day, whether I'm in the grave or the rapture hits. However, amen, that same anointing is going to quicken us out of here. Praise the Lord. God ain't coming after a passive people. He's not coming after a sickly, anemic church. He's coming after a glorious church that is without spot or wrinkle. Glory to God. He's coming, church. Can I get an amen? He's coming. Hallelujah. Psalm 92 says, fresh oil. Amen. It talks about fresh oil. Praise the Lord. And every now in church, we need some fresh oil running in our lives.
Amen.
Because we get depleted pouring out on things and situations and allowing things to bombard our minds and our lives and our family members and our homes and our jobs. Amen. And every now and then you just got to stop and say, it's time to stop wasting. Amen. And wasting. I've seen people, I've had to tell them, look, it's time you stop chasing that. It's time you quit worrying about that person. It's time, amen, because everybody's got a choice and they're going to have to choose this day who they're going to serve. They got a choice whether they're going to live for God or not. But it comes a time you suck it all. Amen. And you, I don't know who this is for tonight. There comes a time you quit wasting oil on something that just don't want to live, don't want to serve God, don't want to do right, and you find you something, amen, that says, give me some oil. Pour some oil out on me. I'll take the anointing. I'll take the Holy Ghost. I'll take, amen, what keeps me up in the morning, amen, and gives me a cup in my step, a smile on my face, an oil grin in my heart, a song, amen, coming out. It gives me what I need for the day. Give me some of the anointing. Hallelujah. Okay. I got this little folder for stuff here in the pages, and some guy in my Bible looks like a scrapbook. And it says, you know, Ephesians 4:29 says, corrupt communication. You know, he says, let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth, but that which is good to the use of edifying, amen, to that may minister grace unto the hearers. You know, this little thought of mine says, what makes up the character of you and I? It says, God took the strength of the mountains, the majesty of the trees, the warmth of a summer sun, the quiet calm of a quiet sea, the gentle soul of nature, amen, the comforting arm of night, the wisdom of the ages, the power of the eagle in flight, the joy of the morning in springs, you know. And he says, the faith of a mustard seed, the patience of eternity, the depth, amen, of a human in need. He wrapped it all up in one little bundle, reached down and got him a dirt ball, a dust out of the earth, formed it all together and made creation and made man in his image. And man, amen, walks with all these characteristics, amen, and these natures of our God, praise the Lord, and God called it creation.
Yeah,
amen.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. No more waste at all. No more waste at all. Some of y'all need what I'm saying here, I'm pretty sure. Wasting oil on things. And some of y'all wasting oil on things you're trying to quit and things you're trying to overcome and things you want to do better. Amen. Quit wasting oil. Amen. Hallelujah. That God says, forget that. Just let me pour some fresh oil on it. Fresh oil. You know, every one of us come here in a vehicle, but if you don't sometimes put fresh oil in that vehicle, you're going to need a motor. You're going to need a new engine. You know, sometimes our vehicles have to be serviced. We as human beings, notice what I said, not human doers, human beings. We are beings on a journey in our church. And a lot of people are human doers, and they don't realize they're human beings that God created, amen? With a purpose, with a plan, with a reason, with a destiny, amen, and it is to change this world we're in,
amen,
for the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. So God began to speak to me about no more wasted oil. No more wasted oil. Wasting oil is wasting time, praise the Lord. And the Bible says we are redeemed the time for the days are evil. Hallelujah. And I look back over some of the churches that I've pastored and wasted so much time chasing people that didn't want to be in church. Yeah. That's going to get tight, but it's going to get right. And wasting time, you know, tracing people and counseling people, that God just stopped me. He said, it's time to stop it. It's time to stop it. Let me tell you something. When Jesus went into his hometown of Nazareth, he preached one time.
Yep.
He preached one time. He couldn't do any mighty miracle, except a few. And they rejected him. And when he left, I can't find it, Pastor. You can help me if I'm wrong. I can't find the scripture where he ever went back to his hometown again. Because he wasn't going to waste any more oil for the prophets that I honor among his own. And he never went back. He never went back because he was rejected. And let me tell you something. If God's not going to waste it, I'm not going to waste it, because the resource of God is precious to me.
Amen.
It's time to run after what God is showing you. Amen. Anoint what God is showing you. Amen. Anoint yourself in areas of your life that needs to be anointed. Ask God to pour some fresh oil out upon it. Amen. That your flesh can be quickened, your spirit can be charged, and your soul can be changed. Amen. Hallelujah. As a fireball for God. Can you amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I'm just kind of shooting this off the cuff. Amen. Hallelujah. Because the Spirit of the Lord, take him out of the picture of this. Take him out of the picture of the church. And guess what? You don't have a church. You just got a
bad church.
You just got yourself a thing, a building, and a gallery. But he's the essence that what makes this run.
Amen.
He's the omnipresence of God Almighty in this earth. He's the agent looking out for me and you. He's the agent, praise the Lord, that comforts us, leads us, guides us, teaches us in all things. Jesus said, I got to get on out of the way, boys. I got to go home. I got to go back where my glory once was. He said, I got to get on back to my throne. I got to get on back up there and see what's going on in heaven and start running the show up there again. But I'm leaving you down here. But I ain't leaving you helpless. I'm not leaving you powerless. I'm not leaving you hopeless. I'm not leaving you in despair. I'm leaving you somebody that's going to help you, going to guide you, going to show you, going to teach you, going to strengthen you, going to help you when you're crying your elbows out, going to help you when you're done the house. Going to work, going to help you when you can't figure it out. I'm not leaving you by yourself. I'm bringing somebody in the picture that's going to be my angel of earth. He's going to be the call from all, and he's going to run the show, and he's going to let my spirit move in the midst.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Ooh, praise the Lord.
Amen.
Thank God.
Thank God for the confidence.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Time to feel the horn. Amen. But fresh oil. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah, there's been enough wasted. Can we agree there's been enough wasted?
Amen.
What in the world are you talking about? This is a spiritual. This is a spiritual application that I'm talking about tonight. This thing I'm talking about not does anything to do with the arm of the flesh or men just trying to build things and build churches and build ministries on the arm of the flesh. This is all about, man, the Spirit of God. He told Zerubbabel, amen, when he was beating his brains out trying to rebuild the temple. Amen. Trying to get the church back up on his feet. And he told Zerubbabel, amen. He sent the prophet to him and said, Tell him, quit wearing himself out. Quit beating his brains out over this thing. It ain't by his might. It ain't by his spirit, but it's by my power, says the Lord. I'm going to do it by my power. And how many know the Holy Ghost is his power?
Amen.
Acts 1 and 8, I give you power.
Amen.
After the Holy Ghost shall come up on you. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, I feel Jesus in here this evening.
Amen.
Amen.
Y'all started that, didn't you?
Been here all day.
But I walked out of it over in where is that place? It's time. Providence. Praise the Lord. I tell you, I get all these little places mixed up in my head. Especially when I get under anointing, then I can't think of one.
Amen.
What's going on? Praise the Lord. But times like this, you know, God reminds us. And some of y'all can reflect in your lives and look back over your lives. You've wasted some stuff. Mm-hmm. Thank you, hon, for that one. Mm-hmm. We've wasted some stuff, church. Mm-hmm. We've wasted stuff and wasted time and wasted efforts and on things, amen. That, how many knows the enemy will get you in places and get you with people and get you with things to wear you out, and you think it's God when it's not, and you're wasting resources and time on something that, amen, that's occupying your time. But God says, I want you to occupy what I've led you into, what I've called you to do, you occupy that. Don't get off into something I ain't told you to do, something I ain't called you to be, or something like that. Just do what I'm appointing and anointing to do. Can you get amen? So, I know that people pull me in self-pastoring mode. If I don't feel God in it, I have no trouble walking away from it.
Amen.
People get mad at me sometimes. Well, you're a preacher, you're supposed to. Because I'm supposed to do what God said to do. I ought to always obey God rather than men. And I got some people, you know, upset with me now because they called and asked me to do a certain thing. And I said, and I prayed about it, and when I prayed about it, God said, forget it, you won't be received there. So he said, just don't even bother with it. And I told them, I said, forget it, we ain't doing it. And of course, they got a little bit out of shape, you know, got a burn under their saddle, but that's okay, I don't care. Wouldn't be the first time I saw a burn under the saddle. How many know there's a time of refreshing?
Amen.
There's a time of refreshing.
That's right.
I don't know if y'all understand the prophetic calendar of God and the prophetic clock of God. I've studied prophecy and preached prophecies for years. But let me tell you something. Y'all might not agree. If you don't, that's fine. You know, but what just took place in Israel when Donald Trump, you know, agreed to appoint Jerusalem, amen, as the capital of Israel, that was a prophetic thing that just took place, church.
Yeah.
That was a prophetic thing that just took place. In 1948, America recognized Israel as a nation and gave them their sovereignty as a nation. Here we are in 2017. The presidents of the United States declared Jerusalem as, amen, the capital of Jerusalem, and all hell's broke loose over it. Amen. But ain't so good a roll they can get over as far as I'm concerned. Because I'm telling you, God's on the move. He's pouring out some fresh oil, Pastor. And he's anointing some things. And what's going on over there in Israel is going to affect what's happening here in America. And God told Abraham, I'm going to bless them that bless you. I'm going to curse them that curse you. And because that took place, you better get ready. Something's going to happen in America. And I don't believe it's going to be for the bad. It's going to be for the good. Something's going to happen. And Pastor, this is what I feel. Something's going to come to the church world, something's going to happen to the church world because of what took place there. God's going to pour it out there. He's going to pour it out here. Amen. This world will know it pays. Amen. Bless Abraham. Bless the seed of Abraham. Bless everything God said bless. And pour it all on the praise. The world praise. Oh, my God. Do it. And do it. And do it. And do it. I'm telling you, this is nothing like a Episcopalian shouting man. Nothing like a Lutheran get happy. Nothing like a wild Protestant get excited. Woo! Thank you, Jesus. So I've been pretty stirred up over that. You know, there's people, man, they bucket the Palestinians are going crazy and this and that. And sad to say, to the charge of the turtle, some of them, I don't believe you should love that. Them people, blah, 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 blah. Let me tell you something. But ignorance built the house, amen. But Hosea 4 says, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. And we do not put our mouth against what God has put his hand upon. We do not come against what God is moving in. And we don't try to shut up what God is shouting from the rooftop. Tell you, amen. Hallelujah. And what God is doing, we don't run with it. Hallelujah. Y'all agree with that?
Yeah.
I'm like, wow. We just made history. We just made history. And I'll tell you the truth. I don't know whether you're for Trump or not. That's your business. You know? But I do know one thing. What he did concerning that was a ka-ching in the heavens.
That's right.
It was a ka-ching in the heavens. Oh, take that, devil. Can't touch that. No. Hallelujah. Oh, praise the Lord. Some of my former days from now. The Bible tells us, amen, that after every series of trials and troubles that's ever hit every generation, there's always came a refreshing. Study history, you'll find it on the text. There always came a refreshing because God began to pour out the oil in the wine, the oil of the Spirit, the oil of gladness on people, praise the Lord. And I don't know, man, the church people across the country, a lot of people are hurting, church. A lot of people are spiritually hurting, physically hurting, financially hurting. Amen. And if I can say nothing else in this place this evening, I want to encourage you, hang on. Hang on. It ain't over by a long shot. This thing's not over. As one brother said, it's getting gooder and gooder. Because we're watching what's going on. Amen. And things, tidbit things. Of course, the big picture is Satan wants you to get your eyes on what you see in the natural. But I'm here to tell you this evening, it's time to get some fresh oil and start by seeing what's going on in the supernatural. Because it ain't over by a long shot. God is never going to lose what he has started. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Amen, little fella. Acts chapter 3, we see where Peter says, you know, repent, amen, hallelujah, therefore to be converted, that your sins may be blotted out, amen, because the refreshing that will come from God is on the way, praise the Lord. And he says the refreshing that shall come from the presence of God. And how many know without the presence of God, there's no refreshing?
Right.
Hallelujah. And this all came from a time of when they came out of the upper room and great miracles and signs and wonders was happening. And then at the gate called Beautiful, a man gets up that's been crippled some 40 years in his feet and gets healed by a supernatural miracle and leaping and praising God in the temple. And all of a sudden, great persecution breaks out against the church. Amen. But Peter instructs him, amen, don't get mad. Don't get tore up. Just repent. Amen. That your sins may be converted. Hallelujah. It blotted out because the refreshing is coming from God. And in Acts chapter 4, we find that in 4:29 it says, and now, Lord, behold their threatenings, and grant, amen, thy service, amen, that with all boldness, amen, they may speak thy words by stretching forth thine hand to heal, and signs and wonders may be done by the name of thy holy child Jesus. And when they had prayed, the place was shaken where they were, amen, were assembled together, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and spake the words of God with boldness. A fresh anointing came upon the church.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I don't think I was supposed to go on the side of the river, don't I? But I will say this. 1 Peter 1:13 says, wherefore gird up the loins of your mind, be sober and holy man to the end, for the grace, amen, that be brought unto you at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. At the revelation of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I don't know who this is for this evening. Maybe all of us, maybe for me, I don't know. But I do know one thing. The word from the messenger this evening. And there's some of you here, you need to stop wasting precious time. Stop wasting precious oil. Stop wasting precious resources on something God has not laid his hand on. And quit trying to change something you can't change in yourself.
That's right.
And let God pour out some fresh oil on it.
Amen.
Because when he touches it, it comes alive.
There you go.
When he breathes on it, it gets the breath of life. When he looks at it, the glory of the Lord shines.
There
you go. And I feel God. He didn't lay his hands on Moses on the Mount of the Mount Sinai. He didn't lay his hand on Moses. He looked at Moses face to face. And Moses came off the mountain from face to face with Israel with a glow on his face. Can you name him? Hallelujah. And he came down with a lot of good fresh stuff for Israel, even though they did what they did. But praise the Lord, church. Man, in the time we're living in, and I believe that God is fixing to shake up or shake America for one of the biggest revivals we've ever seen. It looks desolate right now, but I'm not looking at what I see desolate. I'm looking at, man, that if God don't do this, then he's not going to have much of a church to take out of this world.
Amen.
But he's going to do something before he comes back. I believe that with all my heart. There's going to be an awakening in America that's going to fill the church houses full once again. And they won't come out of fear, amen, and what they did in 9/11, but they're going to come needing God's mercy once again. And the good God I serve says I'll meet them at the mercy seat when they come looking for my mercy. All of them will be running, praise the Lord. All of them will be running. Hallelujah. Stand with me this evening, praise the Lord. We call that my sermon that or whatever, I don't know. It was in my spirit, so I released it. And what you do with it, bring you the Lord. But I do believe there's something in the house today. You've been in that place that you just absolutely buzzed your head. It seems like nothing's changing and nothing's getting better, blah, blah, blah. And it's time, amen, to stop fighting in your own ability and let God's ability get into it. As he told Jehoshaphat, you need not fight. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. What he said in 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse something. We are fighting to learn ourselves to frazzle the people in America. I can't make it more of it, but you can. You can't make it no open, but he can. He closes doors, he opens doors. And I'm going to tell you something else. As I said in the text, God looks on the heart. I can't change a heart. I can tell a heart what is. And I can instruct the heart. But I can't change the heart, Pastor. I can wear myself out trying. And believe you me, I've done that. And I've pastored churches, I've built churches, and all kinds of ministries. And I've worn myself to a frazzle on things. I look back and think, gosh, why did I waste so much time on that when I should have been over here? See, Samuel's over here bawling his eyeballs out over something. God said, it's done. It's done. Get up, man of God. It's done. It's time to move on. I got me somebody over here that I placed in the bloodline of the lineage of my son. And that I have anointed, and he's going to rule and reign, how he is king of Israel. And not only that, one day, my son Messiah is going to rule on the throne of David, and this thing's going to be a kingdom without end, praise God. So, this is time to anoint what God is saying, to anoint, and let go of what God is saying, let go. Can you amen?
Amen.
Having balls, but the walls are good, right?
Amen. Amen. I do too.
I'm going to be here. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Bow your head, women. Father, in Jesus' good name, there be some in the midst, God, of those that would hear, Father, I ask, give them the ear, God, to apply the word and to apply this message in a spiritual application and quit wasting time on something that's just not working, something you have not appointed, something you have not anointed, God, something you have never really even received, and some things, God, you have rejected, Lord, for those that be in the sound of this, God. I pray give them strength to walk away from what's been rejected and embrace what's been received. Embrace, God, what you are doing, and move with what's moving in the Spirit, God, and move with what's anointed, God, and that which is not anointed, God, if it has been appointed, I pray, God, it will line up that it will be anointed. I pray, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. If you're here this evening, you say, man, right there, that's me. I have wasted some stuff. Why don't you come up here? We're going to anoint you with some fresh oil. Fresh oil. Hallelujah. But if not, maybe the Spirit doesn't. I don't know. But I don't believe you sent me in here. You have a different spirit. I wouldn't press and preach at all. I just come by to be here. Oh, Well, once you hand a preacher a microphone, look out. Look out. You might as well get him a brand new set of 44, a Colt 44 to play with. We're going to shoot him. Hallelujah. Got some new faces in the crowd. Got a new family here, I guess. I don't remember this couple. And she's smiling. In Israel, huh? If they like your countenance and your smile, they say, you have a good mask. You have a good mask. You have a good mask. You're getting it, brother. I'm just messing with you. Thank God for these young families.
Amen.
I love to see family, babies, and children in the church.
Amen.
And I see from the older crowd that when it just comes down to us older folks, amen, and we don't have any young things, we better get some fresh oil and we're dying. We're dying. We're dying without these babies and without these young families. I'm hard after the young families because the family is the church, is the unity of the church. God ordained family. He loves family. Praise God. Well, all hearts and minds, please.